Art Allan here. Thanks, everybody, for watching and listening. Today, we are chatting with Sandy Hernandez, the lead actress of a brand new show, which is just absolutely wonderful, The Roar of the Butterflies. I will not butcher it in Spanish. I'll let you say it because I will just totally mess it up. But it's just premiered internationally on Hulu in the U.S., Disney Plus in Europe, and Star Plus in Latin America. A fantastic show. Thank you for your time. It's a pleasure to meet you.
Thanks for having me, Brett.
Yes. And for the, can you give us the Spanish pronunciation, please? I tried it and it just sounds absolutely horrible.
The show is called El Grito de las Mariposas, The okay. Roar of the Butterflies.
Yes. And it's a fantastic project that you are a part of. Super, super good. Now, it's basically inspired by the true historical events of the iconic Dominican lawyer and activist Minerva Mirabal, who was murdered along with her sisters by Rafael Trujillo, which was a known horrible dictator on November 25th in 1960. It's all available to stream now. So let's talk about this project and what it's about. I gave the story byline, but how you all approach it and tell the story.
So it's a fictional drama, like you said, based on the life, the fight, and ultimately the murder of the Mirabal sisters during the Rafael Leonidas Trujillo's regime. And yeah, I get to play Minerva Mirabal, an icon, fighter, mother, sister, wife, who fought against the dictator. And as we know, it ended tragically with the assassination with both of her sisters who fought along her way.
Yeah, yeah. It's a very well-told version of this. And I think audiences will appreciate it when they have an opportunity. Obviously, as a storyteller and actor, you get presented with different projects, but I would imagine this one would stand out from others that you might normally get.
Absolutely. I started auditioning with like another role, but for me, knowing that Disney was interested in telling this story, it's been told many times before, but it was due, you know, to
sure.
Tell it again to the new generations. I always say, like, it feels like it was so long ago, but all those issues that we see in the show, like, still happen this day, you know? So, obviously, super, like, excited for the show. My casting process was like from like a smaller role until I ended up getting Minerva's the lead role. So like you can imagine how that felt. And
sure.
It was a huge responsibility for me to play that icon. I did not take it lightly. It was important for me to prepare, to do, you know, my to be diligent about my investigation. I was able to meet with her daughter in Dominican Republic, and she took me to the museum back in Salcedo. Oh, wow. Where they were born. So it was very like nourishing. I'm a different person, you know, after playing her, I can tell you.
Yeah, I would imagine too, like when you play something that is part of historical fiction and you get to relive those pieces of that person's life, it has to help you in your process as a storyteller, I would imagine.
For sure. Like I had one book in particular that was like my Bible. I had it with me the whole time. And, you know, whenever I needed to like revisit anything from like a specific time, because we were not, I mean, we, it's like a, we do like a 10 year storytelling of like what mm-hmm. happened up until, you know, their assassination. So I tried to like go back to certain moments, and I'm gonna tell you, like I feel like I was literally possessed by her in like some specific scenes, like when my father dies, the day of the assassination when we shot that, it was brutal.
Hmm. Wow, that's so captivating, because I've heard other actors talk about when they play somebody that's real, whether they're currently living, obviously if they were, you would have a chance to talk to them and really get to know them as a person and embody their character. But I think what is important about acting and storytelling, just based on what I've learned, is that you want to garner as much information as you can, do as much research as you can to really embrace the honesty.
Absolutely. And I had a lot of in my advantage, because there aren't any like audio or videos of her. So I was not able to like study her, you know, like visually. So it was like very free, you know, my interpretation and what I was able to build. But for me, it was like trying to embody her essence and, you know, understand her vision, the fight. And I'm very happy with the end work.
Yeah, it's fantastic. So when did storytelling acting become interesting to you? When did you know that you wanted to do it?
I was always involved in the arts since I was little, like ballet. I was in every talent show in my school.
Of course.
some painting. Yeah. So when I was little, I would like grab products from the pantry and like literally make up commercials for my family. I had this character that I would like interpret in my living room. It was like a little grandma. So I was always like very creative. I was an only child until I was 11. So it was me and my imagination, you know. So it was right after high school when I was like, you know what, I'm gonna pursue this. So that's when I enrolled in drama school back in the Dominican Republic. When I graduated, I moved to New York to study acting for film, and then, you know, here I am.
Yeah. And what a career you've had. Well, congratulations on this wonderful and beautiful project. It's available to watch and stream on the networks that we mentioned. We'll be sure to put links for people to check it out. Sandy, thank you for your time. It was a pleasure meeting you and chatting with you today.
Thank you so much, Brad.
Yeah, absolutely. Thank you so much as well.